So we all know this, but I think it's worth repeating. You have to put yourself in the right place at the right time to meet Mr. Right. Kel's here today. So I have been working on putting myself in the right place at the right time in order to meet Mr. Right. So before, I kind of would just go out anywhere that I thought was like gonna be lit or was gonna be fun or popping at that particular time of day, or you know, over whatever weekend. You know, for instance, this weekend everybody's at Caravana, right? So you would think, oh yeah, it's gonna be lit, it's gonna be turn up, that's where I could find Mr. Right, I'm gonna go to Caravana. But actually, now that I've kind of worked on defining who Mr. Right is, and I suggest you guys do the same, once you define kind of who Mr. Right is, like in concrete terms, then you can kind of align that to where you think he might be. So now that I kind of define, you know, who Mr. Right or who I'm looking for in terms of kind of relationship material, I don't think he's gonna be at Caravana. Hence, I'm sitting right here, still in DC. So I have to start thinking about, okay, well, I know Mr. Right, he probably has a career, so maybe he'll be more at happy hours. And you know, depending on the type of career, maybe he would be at happy hours at the Ritz-Carlton in Georgetown as opposed to Marvin's on U Street. And so maybe I should start thinking about heading out to happy hours at the Ritz-Carlton instead of going to Marvin's on Saturday nights, right? So also, going out alone, that's something that I'm practicing, and honestly, it's really, really difficult. It's hard to go out alone and just kind of be awkward, almost like a deer in the headlights type of thing, but really, more quality guys kind of come talk to you when you're by yourself. You just have to kind of work on making yourself feel comfortable in that space, in especially if you're going to like the Ritz-Carlton, you know what I mean? And so, not that you don't already feel comfortable there. When you're out with your girls or with your friends, you probably fit right in, feel right at home. But when you're by yourself, that's a little bit of a different story. So working on going out by yourself and feeling comfortable in the places that you think Mr. Right or, you know, somebody who you're interested in getting to know might be hanging out. And then also learning to say no to certain things. I've gotten some invitations to come to certain parties or certain things, and I've just had to say no because right now I'm focused on myself and I'm focused on finding somebody who is more my type, right? So, and not necessarily me doing the seeking, but definitely putting myself in areas that I think dope people might be. So no to a bunch of different things, no to Caravana, no to Marvin's, no to all these places that you might not find the kind of person that you're looking for, and yes to going out alone, yes to going to maybe higher caliber places to attract maybe a little bit of a higher caliber person or somebody who's more aligned with what you're looking for. Anyway, yeah, so right place, right time, that is what I'm personally working on, and just wanted to share it with you guys just in case it's a little bit helpful to kind of frame how you're thinking about positioning yourself and dating in a city. I do these videos so you know you're not out here alone in this sometimes crazy dating world. If this is your first time here, I'd love to have you subscribe. And if you're a returning viewer, good looking out, thanks for coming back. Remember to hit that subscribe button, as I just said. Hit the bell so you know when I upload, and I will see you guys again in my next one. Bye. Got a brother soft lover just to hide my pound. Got a house in the valley, come and find me now. Got enough dough to buy the town, so I might get